knew at 6 when we were all ordered home during the start of the pandemic, there were fears that this would result in an increase in at-home child injuries, including child abuse. Now the numbers for March and April are coming in, and the University Hospital's Trauma Center found a troubling trend, as well as other ripple effects. Ursula Perry breaks down the numbers from University Health System.
There's good news from the stay-home order. The number of traumas caused by vehicle crashes declined dramatically. 2019 numbers for March and April averaged around 60. This year, we had half that many, down to around 35. It's what happened to the number of gunshot wounds, however, that caught the eye of University Hospital.
Is this really truly a trend, or is it just something that, like, next month we're going to drop back down again? But when we do see such a huge spike, because it's really double the number that we normally have in other months.
Here's what she's talking about. In 2019, there were 3 children injured by gunshot wounds in March and 2 in April. In 2020, during the stay-at-home orders, there were 6 in March and 9 shot in April. Some were no doubt accidental, some were not. But the doctor and others in the community say it's an indication we need to work harder to keep kids safe from guns.
And it is difficult to not be able to socialize or socialize as much with your family members or your social support network. And so I think it does contribute to the additional injuries.
It's important to note that at University Hospital's Adult and Pediatric Level 1 Trauma Center, that even without the huge jump this year in firearm injuries, there has been trending since 2016 that shows this is a problem that is not going in the right direction. Ursula Perry, KSAT 12 News.